Mom and Dad, hi fans. You welcome to my YouTube channel, Mumzibah Talks. Yeah, you welcome to Mumzibah Talks, a channel where we talk about family issues and problems and possible solutions and hacks on how to solve these problems. If this is your first time of meeting me or joining me on my channel, don't forget to click on the subscribe button to become a subscriber and also click on the notification button so you get notified for new videos and family matters. So you're welcome. Today, I'll be talking about the likely causes of get quick wealth in youth slash teens. The likely causes of getting quick wealth in youth slash teens. It is no news that this has been prevailing for some time. This has been a trend that youths want to get quick wealth and do things that are awful to make sure that they get this quick wealth. But also, it's now pinching and more concerned that it is now prevailing in teens, even more than youth. Teens I talk about are people under the categories of 15, 14, 13, 16, and 17. They all want to make quick wealth, and they are not doing this in the right manner. So this is where we have to talk about this. It is a concern and a call to every parent out there. What are the causes? What are the possible causes that has made our teens to have such notions in their mind and such drive to make quick wealth in an ill manner way? Number one of those causes are bad parenting, in quotes of comparison. Parents, most times when they are dishing out punishment and maybe their anger on what those children did to them, their children does to them, or that are not good, they tend to say some words, some things that are awful, that goes far more than words. Let me tell you, parents, words are like they go further than how you say them or how you expect them. They grow to become seeds and even trees in the heart of your little ones. I was involved in a question session with some children who were coming back from school, and these are children under teens, on age of 13, adolescent 15 and 16 or thereabout. And what was my question to them when I just met them and I got them some snacks and we're talking? What they say? I asked them, I said, now, because I was scrolling through my phone and I saw a story where an incident happened in a Nigeria, in Ogun State to be precise, where some group of boys were boiling the heads of kids or of their friend's girlfriend, just because they had some things and they wanted to make money, quick wealth. This is very absurd. And the answer I got from them is that you won't have to blame some children. You won't have to blame some people when they do some things, because our parents are also involved in this. They are who prone us to most of these things. And I was like, what do you mean by such words? I'm going to understand that most time you hear our fathers, when they are angry, you hear them tell you that, is it not that your mate, those your brother, your Uche's son is bringing money for his father since he traveled overseas at a very tender age, he's making money and, you know, buying cars for his parents. Why not? I got to find out that Uche was into some rituals and some killings and so many things out there. So why not? If I can enter this thing, I can also make money. And if I enter into this ritual killings, the first person I'll kill is my parent. I laughed over it, but when I got home, it pricked me. It is true. Parent is a call for you to know things that you say to your children. You don't compare your children. You don't make them feel less of themselves. You don't compare them with other people's children, because you don't know what those people are doing. These go far away than how we think them to be. We might be angry when we are dishing out those words, but it grows far more than words. Number two reason that I'll be calling us to that is one of the likely causes that has led to this get quick wealth among youth, among teens, are number two, depression. Depression has different formats and different mediums through which it is being expressed through different individuals. The way a child of A we react to depression or when he's depressed is different from where child of B will react to when he's depressed. What do I mean? A child, somebody or someone can decide to, when he is depressed, he can express himself by he wants to take his life. Some can decide to, as I am depressed, I feel like being alone. They try to stay away and go into a secret room. They start to stay away from their parents, stay away from their siblings, stay away from everybody that they know. They just want to be alone. They want to talk to themselves. They want to feel comfortable in their own world. That's another format of expression of depression. And some others, they feel when they take someone's life, when they hurt other people, because they feel they've been hurt by other people who has led them into depression. When they hurt other people, they feel happier about it. So out there are many kids who are depressed. Out there are many kids who are faced and teens who are faced with depression. And when the wolves out there throw like a platform to them of cajoling them and brainwashing them, telling them, when you do this, when you kill this person, you can be like this. If you get to hear most of them, they don't even really want that wealth. But because of that depression in them, how they've been rejected by their girlfriends, how they've been rejected by their friends, how they've been rejected by their parents, how they've been demeaned and defamed by their siblings, they feel this is just the best way. So parents, it's a call for us to look out on our children, give them the possible attention. Most time when you see your children retracting to themselves, when you see your children staying away from people, it is a time far from autism. It is a time for us to look at them, understand them, ask them in love, why are you feeling this way? Why are you not behaving the way you used to behave before? And try to understand why they are behaving that way. And if there is any way, perhaps, sure, there will be a way we can help them out of that situation. We have a better situation in the family and a brighter nation and safe nation at large. Number three point that I'll be talking about here is also what has contributed to this get quick wealth among teens and among youth is the religious family. The family does not just end in maybe having a biological setting. We have different formats and different structures of family. We have the grandparents family, we have the biological family, we have the nuclear family, we have other types of family, single parent family, and many more. But children also find themselves in religious setting. What is a family? Family is a group of persons that you live almost half of your life or a lifetime with. So you agree with me here that children also far away from their biological parent, far away from their school setting, they also find themselves in a religious background. And how does this religious background come in relation with what we are talking about? It comes in relation with it because of most backgrounds and most religious settings we find ourselves tend to have this a pattern of categories and defaming, which is very, very bad. You see in some churches, you hear them call, if you want to come and sow a seed, you want to come and tap from the blessing God has given to me, people with the categories of 10,000 come outside. These are great people. People in the categories of 5,000 come outside. These are people that will be reaching the height of a bit greatness of those that is in 10,000 range. People of 2,000 come out. People of 15 era, you can start to come out. This people is maraba nyanya. This people is, you know, some just words that are not supposed to be said. And if parents are not with their children and check proper place where they worship, a place where God accepts equity, it matters. It's a come as you are. So this thing go further than words. These children tend to understand, they start to see it as, are they trying to demean us? They feel defamed. And most of them will say, because people have money, I will do all it takes to have money so that I can be among the top class in this category or whenever I come to the body of Christ. So it is a call to parents that we should also check into all this. Far from the economy, far from the government is not doing too much, we also as parents, we should understand that parenting does not just end when you give birth to your children. Parenting goes far above that. It's a mantle that you carry till you live this life. The day you close your eyes in death, that is the end you end to be a parent to that child. So as long you are alive, you are there to give that child so-called, you are as a parent, it's a great mantle. You are there to give it, your child guidance. Number four, which is the least I'll be talking about, is the pair family. Children normally find themselves among their peers. It is no doubt. These are the people that they spend maybe some of their time with. Or sometimes they can grow old with those their peers around them. What are these parents influencing them over and about? Most parents, we tend to push our children. We don't want to know how they do in school. We don't want to know their friends. It is very, very bad. Most times when your children, like my little kid, when she got into school for the first time, there's something I did. When she came back home, I asked her, oh, who are your new friends? You made new friends today? Oh, yeah, mommy, I made new friends. And she talked about it. She called other names. This one, Ijoma, the other one, Nathan, the other one, Ethan, the other one, that. Oh, Ethan tickled me here. Ethan. People will see it as, what does that mean? It goes far. Sometimes it's also good you have a date with your friends, a time where you go out with your children and also their friends are involved. Sometimes you can invite them for a meal in the house. Sometimes you can invite them for program. You watch TV together, you watch movies together. And when they are watching those movies, you try to hear their comments. You ask them what they've learned and you guide them. So by so doing, I know we have great families. I know also through this, we have a better nation and a safe nation. Thank you so much for watching and thank you so much for joining me. Bye now and see you next.